Hello and happy gaming, everybody. My name is Darksade Walker, and if you can't tell by the setup in the lower left-hand corner, we're trying it again. We're gonna try the old puncher build. So we've got Earth Knuckles, Fueled Berserk, Spark Array to try to keep my enemies from escaping, Chaotic Rift for the dodging, Tempo for the movement speed and the cooldown reduction. That's right, we're giving it another go. Last time I tried this build, I got clobbered. Not badly, but just in the end, I couldn't outlast my enemies. And I think the reason being is because I was trying to approach it like a slugger. You know, just get in there, hit hard, hit as hard as you can, and try to shrug off the damage. And you know, I wasn't going to say anything, but the only thing that could make this not work out very well would be to see both Shu and Atlas. Well, how do I feel about that now? Alright. Well, I've said multiple times, I know my luck. Alright, so let's play this smart. Don't just go running in like a madman. Okay. Something is up with my controller. Like, it's just randomly disconnecting. I don't really understand what's going on there. Just for some reason, the game decided, oh, you should hold still for a while now. Oh, what's that, Bluetooth controller? Well, it's trying to do it again. So, like I was saying before my controller decided to just not respond to me, last time I did this, I was trying to approach this like in the classic Mike Tyson kind of slugger style. This time around, we're taking a much more Muhammed Ali approach. We're gonna try the outboxer approach. And if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, just go check out some footage of boxers. There actually are a number of accepted styles of boxing. To put it into perspective, and yes, I do want gale force alignment. Booyah. Your slugger is essentially your big heavy hitter. They don't care if they take much damage. They just want to get in and get those big hits as fast as they can. They're essentially like, I guess a good way to put it is they're like your tank. So hey, I noticed you just interrupted my spell. I don't appreciate that. An outboxer will use fancy footwork to dodge around their opponents and. Do their best to just score blows of opportunity after sidestepping or dodging a punch. So they're like your more nimble rogues. I mean, if you can call a boxer anything close to a nimble rogue. And there's a third type of boxer, but the name of it eludes me, but their whole goal is to go like multi-hit. They just get in there and score as many quick hits as possible to try to tire their opponent out. Much like last time, I'm having a difficult time of it because I'm Okay, well, sturdy wooden easel and memory chainmail are both really good options. I'll probably end up taking the sturdy wooden easel. But in comparison, last time I was trying to run it as if I were a slugger. This time I'm going for a more outboxer approach. And we will see how it works. Wow, Dark Sage, how do you know so much about boxing? I don't. But then again, I think we all saw the death battle episode of Balrog versus TJ combo, right? But I mean, yeah, looking up the information afterwards, it all pans out. And there's a nice big wallop to finish it off. Where are you? Bladed buckler. I destroy enemy projectiles and get signature charge. Woot. Alright, sturdy wooden easel, you're coming with me. Yes, Cecil, outboxer. You heard me. So, I guess to put it another way is I'm kind of playing a Muhammed Ali build. Or at least trying to play with that mindset, because the build looks more like I just ran in and started rapid jabbing with Little Mac. Mama said, knock you out. You're gonna be hearing that a lot throughout this episode, so just get used to it. Out of the way, bird. Alright, nothing there really catches my fancy, so we're hoping to see some good arcana from Iris's shop. And of course another dead end, because why not? Alright, so now let's play it smart. Before we enter another combat room, let's wait for Fueled Berserk to come back up. There we go. Put my enemies in a bad spot, capitalize. Bob and Weave, step in, knock a motherfucker out. I mean, that's essentially how boxing works, right? You just step in, you bob and weave, and then you knock a motherfucker out. There we go. A box! Man, you know I can't withstand the allure of a box. Good job, me. Alright, so what the box actually does is Relic and Arcana stores instantly restock after a purchase, but not health potions, because that would be cheating. Ow. I timed my dodge wrong. Or my punch, I should say. I wasn't being an outboxer, I was trying to slug. That's what got me killed on this run last time. Lessons have not been learned. Follies have been ignored. And throw a punch. There we go, that's more outboxer right there. That's more Muhammad Ali. Nice to keep in mind, I don't really watch boxing at all. I'm not I'm not big into the sport, and it's not, it's about as rudimentary as a sport gets. You basically take turns punching a guy until one of you falls over. Presto changeo, you've got boxing. Now, on the higher level versions of those guys, I'm going to have to dodge around behind them and then be like, oh, what was that? Ah, sucker punch. There we go. So, with this build, my main source of damage is definitely my basic, so if I see sharpened stylus, now I would take it. Step, dodge, strike back. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. That's what the man said, anyway. And you know, I trust his advice. What are you? Flame breath. Waha! It's a nice close range damage dealer. Can't go wrong with that. Of course, I kind of like Inferno Cannon better, but first. So now I only get one hit, but it's a really big fist. Try not to take that out of context, but there you go, giant fist. Punch! Punch! Falcon! Punch! There we go. That's looking solid. Alright, was there anything here that I really wanted at all? Well, I mean, that'll help up until the end. A little bit of defense never hurt anybody, but now I really could use some offensive relics. Either critical hit boosting or... critical hit boosting or damage up, either one will help. Flame breath! Owie. Yeah! Now everybody say it with me. Mama said, knock you out! No evading Zephyr for me. Thank you. Thank you, good night. I'm aware that that's probably the big combo with the Fueled Berserk is you go Fueled Berserk, then evading Zephyr, and then you just go nuts. But I kind of prefer to take the approach that I've got going on. The approach that I've got going on seems, I don't know, less mindless, but I just want to let everyone know that I am cognizant of what I passed up on. And some of you will even be going, God damn it, Dark Sage, you did it wrong! I mean, yeah, maybe that's not the popular combo, but the fact of the matter is, I'm still the one playing the game, right? Huh. You fools, did you think I didn't learn my lesson from the last time I tried this? No, you'll not make a fool of me again. Boop, 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 boop. Oh, the room is clear. I knew that. Dash around. Yeah, shut up. There's Thorn's gauntlets! Okay, so once again, there's nothing there that's really all that great. The carbonation! It caught me by surprise! Ha! You take me for the fool that I am! Even the birds are like, are you sure that's how that phrase goes? They're like screaming at me like, what did he say? He just said he was a fool! Alright. Keep it cool, keep it smooth. Remember the man's advice. Float like a butterfly, sting like an Air Force Stinger missile. That's what they said, right? Something like that. Float like a butterfly, sting like a rapier. Outboxer, bitch! Never underestimate the power of Muhammed Ali! By the way, going back to the Street Fighter reference, is that kind of what Dudley is supposed to be? Is Dudley supposed to be Muhammed Ali, or is he somebody else? Because I know Balrog is supposed to be Mike Tyson. I don't know, all I know is that Balrog's slugger style didn't work for me, so I'm trying Ali's style. But, yeah, so if someone knows the kind of design doc influence behind Dudley from the Street Fighter series, by all means, someone let me know. Yes, make me faster, make my cooldowns better. I am A-okay with losing 100 health, mostly because I'll probably get it back pretty quickly. Assuming I don't do anything stupid. Like I said, not gonna be able to just stand there and box them down. No, we're going to need to actually teleport behind them, and then go for the old back of the head sucker punch. I know what some of you might be thinking, but no, I'm not going to say that. Not that I have a reason not to. I just think it's a little bit more clever to just not go for the obvious dirty-minded example. But just so that we're all on the same page, yes, I'm absolutely thinking it. Yeah, sir, you're still selling trash. Get me the captain's ring! That is what I want! The captain's ring or the analytical monocle. Or whatever else will make me do thousands of damage per hit.
Thousands of damage per hit? What does he think he's doing?
Cocaine. Oh, okay. God. No. I will smash your face into dust. And then I will pound you like a cheap steak. Alright, what do we got over here? Ooh, upgraded gale force alignment. Yes, and thank you. Alright, smash these barrels. Alright, nothing fun there. and then I took away his weapons. Both of them. There are some scenes in movies where just that visceral punch is just what the doctor ordered. And it feels so good just to trap an enemy up against the wall and just go, beat your fucking bloody face in! Oh my god, yes! It's so satisfying! Unlike The Last of Us 2! Oh, I'm sorry, did I say that out loud? And I'm glad I didn't spend money on the game, but my after seeing what everyone got so upset about, I was like, God, could you have done the old characters any more disservice just because you're fucking in love with this, with essentially She-Hulk? Ugh. Anyway, this isn't an episode for me to talk about that. Just understand, yes, it's on my mind, yes, it pisses me off. Simultaneously, this is not the Last of Us 2 Get Pissed episode. This is the I'm Muhammed Ali episode. And now I smash your face into dirt.
Oh no!
I tried to teleport out of the way of the rogue slash, but I mistimed it.
Get loopy.
No, I'm not getting rid of Fueled Berserk. Are you crazy? Are you a madman? That's the entire thing behind which this run is built! I can't just get rid of it. Not for a random gamble. Ha! Can't keep up with my speed, can ya? No, of course you can't. Cause you're a jumping idiot with a block. And furthermore, why are you using a weighted companion cube as a weapon? That's just very rude and uncouth of you. Oh wait, it's got a skull on it. Hold on, that's not a weighted companion cube at all! I believe that's his cousin. Yes, fiery paintbrush, that'll work. Is there anything else I want to go with this? Dice of the Nemesis. Something that rhymes with this. See, this is why I'm not a rapper. This is why I basically just play video games. Which is not to say that I think rapping is the most rare talent in the world. Some people just have a talent for being able to just pull that off. And again, most rappers also have professional writers to help them out with their lyrics. Very few of them just go up on stage and they're like, "Mighty rhyme time! Drinking lemon lime!" Like I told you, I'm not good at this. Pathfinder's knapsack, thank you very much. Helping me out when the times are tough. Earth pun! Okay, yeah, Atlas is totally knowledgeable about how to stop my shit. It's alright, I've got other methods. What in the world was that, Atlas? I just wanted that hug, man. So either you're like the world's most muscular hippie, or you've got things going on in your head that you're not telling everyone else. Hey Dark Sage, how come you always go right first? Of course a habit. Punch, punch, punch. There you go. Woo! Alright. Wait for Fueled Berserk to be ready to use again. So this is probably one area where the Chaotic Pendulum build would actually make a lot of sense. But considering how quick the enemies are and how much extra damage they do, I'm not sure I can pull that off properly. Punch, punch, punch. Ah, Golem Dick Punch. There we go. There you go, 310 damage punch. It might not be 1,000 damage, but you know what? It's damage. It's good damage. Knock that guy right the hell out. And there we go. See, this is looking a lot better than when I tried this build the last time. Last time it just didn't go so well. Like I said, I was trying to be a slugger, and being a slugger doesn't work. It doesn't really work for this build, nor really for this game, honestly. Actually, that's not entirely true. There are slugger-like setups that work just fine, but for the most part, you've got to really focus on getting around your enemy's garbage. Slow punch. Punch. Two punches and he's done. Why are you offering me that? Like, the only reason why I feel I see it so often is not because it's necessarily showing up more often than anything else. It's just this factor of what? Oh, I already, cute. Cute, buddy, cute. That'll help. I don't know about Wings of Icarus. Okay, someone please give me some sort of damage up relic.
You seem to be doing just fine without it.
Yeah, but I'd like to do better. See, that's the point. Just because I can go without doesn't mean that that's necessarily what we're interested in seeing. Oh, really? Yeah, that's what you get. Next time, don't mess with Muhammed Ali, wizard. Didn't you know that was his full name? Yeah, Muhammed Ali, wizard. No one really put two and two together because he was. They just figured, oh, he must have. He's of Arab descent. That must be it. It's just one of their last names, you know, wizard, Muhammed Ali wizard. It's just the slang. No.
Hey, Dark Sage, I'm pretty sure you don't know what you're talking about.
Shh. Look, if everyone else on the internet can just pop up and just say random things without knowing what the hell they're talking about, then so can I. Besides, we all know what we really came here for, Golem Dick Punch. Why on today of all days, I'm like, okay, this would be a great time to get some damage up so we can see just how much damage these punches are really gonna do. No, the game is just like, you wanna do damage? What a strange concept. Okay, too many assholes. Stop summoning all your buddies. Okay, this is absolutely not an ideal place to have this build. Okay, that was absolutely god-awful. I would like to hope that that never happens again. Vessa, help me out here. I'm just so upset. Well, you know, even... outboxers are strong and all, but they tend to not do very well against swarms. Got a point. Simultaneously, golem dick punch.
What does that have to do with it?
No, he's got a point.
Punch, there we go.
Whee! Is this another battle room? Kind of. There we go. After a healthy diet of knuckle sandwiches, the knights felt the best thing they could do was take a nice nap. After all, after getting all of that protein, not to mention calcium, they needed their time to rest and recover for the coming journey. Are you just going in circles? No, Vessa, I know where I'm going. Doesn't seem like you do. Well, see, to the untrained eye, that might be the case. There we go. Sweet. Alright, so that works exactly as I thought it did. Basically, what Fueled Berserk is doing is removing the limit on the combo. So, whereas... it would count that one punch as the end of the combo normally, if I've got Fueled Berserk up, then it just doesn't really recognize the end of a combo. It's just like, oh, you'll just keep going, it's okay. Today's episode brought to you by potential Chinese racism. Doesn't have to be Chinese, could be Taiwanese. Might be Japanese, how do you know? Oh, there's the sharpened stylus. Okay, oh, throwaway box. Oh, whoops, I was looking for bladed bracers, not sharpened stylus. Oopsie poopsie. Oh well. It's fine, this'll still work out absolutely okay. Because it's not the signature that's the selling point of this run. It helps, but I'm getting to the point where it's going to be mostly bosses now. I've no love for ghouls. Or beam cyclopses. Matter of fact, if you're trying to kill me, just expect that I don't like you very much. Oh, there's a newsflash, thanks. Iris, what are you selling? God, I love Tracer Barrage. But is that better than my current Flame Breath currently? I'm going to say probably not. Also, yes, I see lightning aspect there, but... I say no. Not that I think it's, like, terrible or anything. Again, it would probably combine very well with the Fueled Berserk style run I've got going on right now. But I want to make sure I have enough money if in case I need to buy a health potion. That, and if I put all my eggs into the punch it basket, then once again we've got the problem of we're trying to be a slugger. And we know how well that works. Yeah, that was a lot better. I don't know what made that so much different. Oh, and now the clover. Yeah, and why do you people do this to me? At the very end, you start giving me the things that I want? Alright, well, you know what? Fine. Sharpened stylus, crimson clover, Pathfinder's knapsack. We'll make it all work. Alright, now we've got Muhammed Ali Wizard versus Flame Empress Zia. We've got boxing version versus her, what is it, Taekwondo? Is it just Kung Fu? Like, I'm not sure what type of martial arts she practices. I know there's a lot of kicks involved. It looks like Kung Fu to me, but... Like, matter of fact, until someone tells me otherwise, I'm just gonna assume it is Kung Fu. It's a very aggressive style, whatever it is. Might be Taekwondo, actually.
Why, thank you.
Shattering Strike. Not bad. I can actually see this being not only a bit more useful for the coming fights, thanks to it having an area of effect and potentially allowing me to hit a few of the Null Flash agents if they're bundled up. Simultaneously, it's also going to boost the sturdy wooden easel. That does bring up the problem of what about the fiery paintbrush? I do have both. That is a good point. So I think what I'll do is I will... Get against that wall. Yeah. And, oh, lovely. Crash Knight again. There we go. Okay, not bad. Did I pick up all of the health orbs back here? Nope. Okay. Any sort of good things showing up here? Not really? Okay. Well, we're just going in like this. It's alright. You didn't get to face me with this build last time. Time has come to face your reckoning, sir.
What kind of a wizard is this? He's so primal.
Alright, after your next attack. Oh, come on. You can do better than that. Stop trying to hit me and hit me! Thank you. Stupid null flash agent. Ow. Sometimes you just can't beat a good solid fistance.
Darkseid, did you really mean for it to sound like that?
Shh. But I think the better question is, do you think that I meant for it to sound like that? Damn, that didn't work. Didn't even beat him with the punch, beat him with the activation of Fueled Berserk. My goodness. Alright, well there you go. Taking a more outboxer approach to this build actually secured the win. Do I recommend taking Earthen Knuckles at all times? Oh, hell no. It's entirely too slow without Fueled Berserk to really be worth anything. On the other hand, with Fueled Berserk, it is actually rather worthwhile. So take that with you. If at some point or another I decide to do a Wizard of Legend Basic Arcana tier list, now you have some ideas to where I would put Earthen Knuckles. So thank you very much for watching. This was actually a lot of fun. I might end up doing this build again with a slightly different idea behind it, but I'd say for right now we've got ourselves something solid here. So thank you very much for watching, thank you for all of your support, and I will see you guys in another video. My name is Darkseid Walker, and I will be seeing you.